Hello there. I wish this thing didn't turn off at 30 minutes, but it did. You missed, there was a little bit of a boom on that one. I kind of don't think you got it. But I was talking, I don't even know if you got that. There's a big reaction between oak, the acids in the oak and steel. And this thing sat on the carriage all night. And see where it got a hold of it that quick. So, kind of interesting. Thought you might want to come along for that trip. Now is what you do is you pull it till it's flat on all these things. Then I don't know if you're in here. I'm guessing you are. Take out the tension, pull the dog down. Take out the tension. I don't know that you're on there. Take out the slop. Watch out for them dogs. They should all be in the same position. Then you know if you got one cleared, you got all cleared, but my dogs aren't. The distance between here and here isn't equal on all my dogs, which is not a good thing, but a little sawdust on you guys. Well, I'm gonna take a slab off of there. I guess I gotta come down and get this nonsense out of here a little bit so we can get the next slab off and get it out of the way, because then after that slab comes off, boards are coming off. So this is a heavy chunk of wood here, guys. This is a heavy chunk of wood. Heavy. So we'll let that sit right there. We'll let this, oh my goodness, I can't even pull it. That bad boy's heavy. I got my little electric baby chainsaw here. Except I don't, oh, here's my measuring stick. What I do is I just come up with this. I'm not gonna do that right now. That one there really needs the gas chainsaw. But it's so long. Has about had it. You know, that swung right around and hit me in the shin. That wasn't very polite of it. New benches. Measuring stick. Measure everything here, guys. Some room. And some nice wood. I'll have to split that. That's such big. Yeah, we'll split that by hand. All right, let's get another big piece over there. See, it don't take too long to get all this mess cleaned up. The old Detroit was smoking quite a bit when I bit into that log that last time. Imagine the teeth must be getting dull or something. I'm not sure. So put your ears on. Here we go again. be an ugly log. I don't know what I'm gonna do with it, so I don't want it to, I can always saw it up later. But I think you're zoomed out. This board here is almost useless. I mean, you only got the top few inches. Now you got a piece down here that's all right, which that's only about 4.5 feet long. It was a little further to this. Well, I don't know. This has got the knot up here and knot up there. So it's really, you know, for you can make a nice piece of something out of here. This is actually quarter sawed right there because the way that center is on that. And I'm just playing around anyway. So I think I might pull this back. See, it's got like I told you, it was not a good board to begin with. You got this is taken off this whole section of this board. Then this has got it up here. This has got it on that face. On this face over here, you got it's full of knots, but that's not too bad. That's doable. You got another big one over here. Up here, I don't know, I guess the camera's got it. It's full of sawdust. I don't know where the heart's at. You got one heart here right now. So the favorable board would be, like I said, you cut in this way here, but you're only going to get 4 foot boards because it's about 8 foot long and that's about center. So all this is junk. Up here you got a heart there. I think we've cut out the second heart out of this thing. Anyhow, I'm gonna roll back and try to put it on those two beds back there, try to bounce it on that. I guess you'll see that bouncing act. And it might work, it might not. I'd be better off bringing it down here. Maybe I'll do that, clear up some of that stuff, but it's gonna take a lot longer. Be a lot better off bringing it down to this side than putting it on the rollers. But then I have to get rid of the slab wood down there. That's smarter to bring it down to this side. I don't want to really bounce it. I got to do trims on all those boards that are up there, so to make it harder access on the trims. My mind is, I guess, so little it changes constantly. If I can get this stuff out of the way and get these up here, I think I'll bring it down here and just let it sit in limbo until I can think what I want to do with it. Of course, I don't really want to have all this slop wood here either. But I guess that'll be all right. We'll deal with that when you guys aren't on the camera time. That's gotta go down a little bit further, but I don't want to. These are right heavy. Heavy for an old man. Got two of them at that time. Oh man, ain't quite one. Yeah, it is. I like to keep it up on these. There we go. Once you get the first stack up, you're all right. So that gets these out of the way. Those are some big timbers. I guess on that first cut where it went fat and thin or whatever, because I didn't shave it. It was probably because of that big knot in there. It just pulled it. You know, those knots pull it like you wouldn't believe. So I'm gonna start up the saw, bring that thing down here. I'll bring you guys along. about 12 by 12. By 12 and a quarter. It's a heavy piece. Oh, I forgot to bring the cat hook down too. Along for some of that trim to make a video. But I want to save the boards back to that side.